Welcome back, everybody, to the Carolina Panthers franchise here going into Week 12. Take on the Chicago Bears, and this should be a very good matchup. Taking on the two-time MVP, Mitchell Trubisky. Never thought you would hear those words together with his name, but he is MVP. Bears trying to get back at it here. He's almost looking for a third MVP. He's right there at the top of the boards there for his third MVP in a row, having a fantastic season. But we're having a fantastic season as well, coming off a huge win against the Seahawks last week. And you can see we're right behind Dallas right there at 8-2. They are at 8-2 as well. Bears at 7-3, trying to get right back at it there and trying to take over the spot at the moment for that bye. So here we go in Chicago, week number 12, and we'll receive the ball first. Good return up to around the 31-yard line. And that's where this offense will start. So this offense the last 3 weeks has been fantastic. They have been looking a lot better since that abysmal two-game losing streak. They're looking good here. Christian McCaffrey had a really good week last week, almost 200 yards rushing. So let's see what we can do here against a pretty tough Bears defense. That's a good start there. Good read option play, picks up the first down. Hand off to McCaffrey, not really going anywhere there. Eddie Goldman there with the stop. So third down and 10, got to keep away from these. Obviously, Khalil Mack there going out to the outside, trying to find DJ Moore, but that's not going to be knocked away by Fuller. Incomplete. So the Bears force the punt, and here he comes, the MVP, Mitchell Trubisky, 26 touchdowns, only 4 interceptions, playing well, 7-3, so I can see why. Obviously, going to have a little bit different with David Montgomery on the ground. No Tariq Cohen this week. He is out, so it's going to be all Montgomery here. 2nd and 3 from the 27-yard line after picking up 7 yards there, and he's going to have a nice run here as well. So Montgomery looking good there, picks up 8, first down up to the 35-yard line, even though without Cohen. Cohen gives you that, you know, targeting the receiving game, that explosiveness. Montgomery is still a fantastic back, nice young running back, so he can fill in well as Trubisky's going to find Allen Robinson there for the catch. First down, Bears moving in here on the first drive. So 2nd and 11, back on the ground. This is another Cohen, so a different Cohen here on the ground for the Bears, but going absolutely nowhere. That's going to be a loss. And now 3rd and 13, they're actually going to make a draw play here, and that's not even going to be close to the first down. Not sure the play call there. It's almost like you're going to go for it, but they aren't. So they're going to punt it back on the ball. So 2 stops by both defenses, and we're back to square one here. With McCaffrey with the run. He makes a move on Eddie Jackson. Can he make a move? He can there. And he's down or up to the 45-yard line. So McCaffrey, obviously, with the injury problems last week, really shined. Hopefully he can stay healthy with no Dalvin Cook for obviously the next few weeks. I'm hoping he can just, you know, be the Christian McCaffrey you expected to be and really just take over. He did last week, and hopefully he can do here from continue on. So 2nd and 10. Fields looking around, has a man, and that's going to be Henry Ruggs for the catch. Using his speed, he burns around Fuller for the touchdown. 32 yards. Man, Henry Ruggs showing off the burners there. That wasn't even close. Touchdown there. We'll take a 7-0 lead. That was outstanding. So now let's see what the defense could do as Keekly's going to lay out Montgomery there. Picks up around 3 yards. They'll give him 4. So 2nd and 6, back to the ground. And they're working it here. It is working for Chicago as Montgomery up the middle picks up another first down up to the 42-yard line. So looking good here so far. 5 for 31 and trying to control the ball here. 3rd and 10, though, for Trubisky and company. Burns comes around. But what a play by Trubisky. Miller was coming in, closing in as well. He finds his check down there, Montgomery, for a first down. So David Montgomery having a fantastic beginning of the game here. 1st and 10, though, Luke Kuechly comes in and he picks up the sack. Obviously, this defensive line has just been outstanding the last few games, picking up Cleveland Farrell on the trade. But on a 2nd and 17, Allen Robinson's going to beat Dante Jackson. Not sure what happened there, 30 yards. But yeah, when you don't when you can throw it that quick, you don't really have to worry about the pass rush coming, which has been just absolutely fantastic for this team. 1st and 10. Oh man, what a throw there. As the rookie Sapp just couldn't get his head turned around in time. Obviously, with Delpit there, maybe that could be an interception, but finds Trey Burton there, and the Bears down to the 4. 2nd and goal. Trubisky looking around. Has plenty of time, but nobody open. He's going to take it himself, makes a move, but going to be pulled down. Cleveland Farrell with the tackle, but he pulled him down by the face mask. That's going to be an automatic first down. put him down to the two, first and goal now instead of a third and goal. So Jabrisky, first and goal, looking around, goes to the back of the end zone, and Keekly is going to knock that one away. Third and goal now. Trubisky to the outside. Going to find Trey Burton, but nice job. Dante Jackson, Von Miller there to make the stop. We'll hold Chicago to three. And it's 7-3 here. And this might be the last play of this first quarter as Fields looking. Just going to dump this one off to McCaffrey. Makes the juke move. And he'll pick up around 12 to 13 yards there. First down. And that is a nice play there. So McCaffrey getting involved all around, obviously the all-around back. Second and five. This time it's going to be DJ Moore for the catch and first down after the blitz coming. So nice job by Fields. Looking a lot better here the last few weeks. Here goes Bo Scarborough, who actually had a fantastic debut last week as well. Third and one. We'll keep it with Fields, and that is not going to work out. So, yeah, kept it because the end crashed there on McCaffrey. Didn't work at what you wanted there, but now we have a field goal opportunity here, about 55 yards. Josh Lambeau is just going to have enough. It's up and it's good. So 10-3, we get the field goal back, and let's go back to the defense after the Bears had a pretty successful drive, but this time it starts off not what they wanted. Tamani Hills, almost the forgotten man here, comes up with the sack, puts him back to the 22-yard line, and now Trubisky on 3rd and 11, she's going to dump it down to Burton. Nicholson is there for the stop, so our defense continuing to remain tough, fantastic, you know, forcing teams to throw quick because our pass rush is so fantastic that they got to just get rid of that ball, and, you know, our tackling has been great in open space, and, you know, the defense is making big-time stops, and the offense is taking advantage. McCaffrey with the run there. First down, first and 10 now. Fields looking around. He's going to throw it. Has a man. What a throw there. That is going to be a first down to Neek Hill. Harry, he's up to the 36-yard line. Great job finding the receiver, and great job by Harry getting the 2 feet down in bounds. Second and six. Flag on the play. Man, nice blitz pickup there. Fields would have been done for. Gets out of the pocket, slides down. Is going to be holding, but man, that could have been a sack. That was a great job picking up the blitz there. I think was that Scarborough who picked it up. Second and 16. Fields now looking. Watch out. Blitz coming, and he goes down. Burns, Artie Burns comes in there. Back to the 19, and now this is going to be a third and 27. Just got to be careful here. Just don't go crazy. As Fields looking, just going to dump this one off to Ruggs. He'll pick up what he can. Picks up around 8 there up to the 27-yard line. So punt. Great job by the Chicago defense. Penalty did definitely hurt us. Would have had the first down there with Fields. So forcing the punt. Bears offense back at it, and David Montgomery back at it as well, picking up a few yards there. Now a 3rd and 4, Trubisky blitz, but he finds his man, Trey Burton. So Burton with the big catch there on 3rd down, picks up the first down there as Trubisky just getting better of the ball right before Sherrod was there for the sack. But another big 3rd down, 3rd and 2, flag on the play. He'll dump this one down. That'll be a first down, but I'm guessing this one's going to come back. It is. That is going to be a holding call. So instead of a first down for Chicago, Charles Leno picks up the holding call and drops this back to a 3rd and 12. So Trubisky blitz coming, goes up top. A little bit of miscommunication, but it's going to work out in their favor. As Dontrell Sherrod maybe freaked out a little bit there, pulls down the receiver. That's going to be pass interference. First down Chicago. 2:12 left, but Isaiah Simmons is going to pick up the interception. So huge play by the defense here with 2 minutes left in this first half. Obviously only a 7-point game. So if we get the stop, we got the stop here, a chance to pick up some points here before halftime with great field position at the 45. So 2nd and 10, pitch to McCaffrey, and he gets to the outside, and he's going to be stopped down. Good gain there around 7. And brings up a 3rd and 3. Can we take advantage of the turnover? We're going to get it to the outside. Find DJ Moore on the slant. That's going to be a first down to the 40-yard line. Obviously, we got 2 timeouts here. Plenty of time. Don't really have to rush around here. 1st and 10. And that's going to go down for a sack. Akeem Hicks in there to bring down Fields back to the 45-yard line. Our offensive line has really been good the last few games protecting the quarterback Fields, but obviously with this Bears defensive line, they're fantastic. But what a play by Fields. Getting out, find his receiver, lobs it down to Ingram, down to the 17-yard line. We'll use a timeout there. 32 seconds left here in this first half. 1st and 10. Just a 4-man rush. Fields looking. Goes to the outside of McCaffrey. McCaffrey going to pick up around 9 there, down to the 8. So, second and one. We used our last timeout. Fields is going to find Ingram in the back of the end zone for the touchdown. What happened to the Bears' defense there? Nobody covering Ingram in the back of the end zone. Perfect throw by Fields. We get the touchdown, take advantage of the Isaiah Simmons interception, and instead of a 10-3 halftime score, we go in at 17-3, looking good. The run game is working. Pass game, the offense has been fantastic, and so has the defense, and we'll see if we can continue it here in the second half and get a victory here in Chicago. So we head down to Tampa. Season not looking good for them. Obviously, look like they're going to go to 2-9 with Pittsburgh with the 21-7 lead as the Steelers trying to win that AFC North. And we head to Atlanta. So big game here. Seattle, we beat last week 24-7 over Atlanta. So Atlanta needs every victory they can get. But, man, down big there, and that could cost them. You never know for the wild card. We'll see. But Atlanta losing there might go to 5-6. As we get back into this second half, as we are trying to go to 9-2 on the season. So second and nine, Montgomery, who had a very good first half, another rush there, and he's close to another first down. But on third and one, it does not work out in their favor. They go to Allen Robinson on the outside, but Fuller is right there. So not sure what the play call there. You know, you're running the ball decently. Why not just go back to David Montgomery and try to pick up the first down? But does not, they don't do that for Chicago. Force a punt. And here comes their offense, 3rd and 13, Fields looking, trying to get any, he's just going to throw it up, dangerous throw, but DJ Moore comes away with the catch, and he breaks off the tackle, and has a first down. Wow, that was a little wild there. Picks up the first down somehow, I don't know, so instead of a punt, we'll continue this drive now. 2nd and 7, Fields with a run, plenty of room to run, he dives forward, but he fumbles the ball. Oh, man, Fuller is there to pick this one up. All he had to do was slide down there. He just dives, somehow loses the ball, and now Chicago takes over. But our defense can almost get it back as the other Fuller, the brother there, almost has a pick six there. So 3rd and 10, and that's going to be almost intercepted again. Nice play there by Dante Jackson. Keekly could have had the pick. So at least we force a 3-and-out. The fumble does not matter, and let's get this offense back on the field. Dangerous throw over the head of Eddie Jackson, and he finds Henry Ruggs. Man, we're getting some lucky plays here. 28 yards there to Ruggs. First down. 1st and 10. Back to the run game with McCaffrey. One man to beat, and he does with a spin move, and he's going to beat the other man. McCaffrey at the 5. Touchdown. Christian McCaffrey. 10th rushing touchdown of the season. But this is what we expect from him. Look at these moves here. Spin move, not going to get him there. And then the juke move right back, getting the speed to beat Leonard Floyd for the touchdown. Christian McCaffrey backing up the great week he had last week. What looks like another good one here against a very tough defense. And we've taken this up to a 24-3 lead here with 5:30 left. In this third quarter, 3rd and 3, they'll have the catch, first down to Montgomery. So the Bears, that would have been really bad for them to go 3-and-out and give our offense the ball right back. So at least they get a first down there. 2nd and 10, flag on the play already. Trubisky looking, going up top, and it's going to be knocked away, incomplete. But that flag so early, that's probably going to be a holding call. It is. So that's going to knock them back. And it's going to be now with that penalty and a third down here, 3rd and 21. From the 22-yard line, Trubisky's going to get his receiver to the outside, but just so far back, that penalty call really hurt him there. They force another punt, our defense, and now with 3:15 left, let's see what we can do here. A lot of room to go with, trying to just waste some clock here. Ingram with the catch, first down to the 28-yard line. Fields, he's almost just been a different quarterback. He looks like he's getting a lot more comfortable, obviously getting a lot more games under his belt. He is looking good, the run game working, so Fields is looking like the quarterback that we drafted and really put in there. And obviously, he won a Super Bowl last year coming off the bench with Drew Lock being hurt. But now he is looking like the guy, the reason why we decided to go away from Drew Lock and keep Justin Fields. He is looking like that now, starting to look like that. 3rd and 15, just going to dump it down to Ingram. And I actually don't think he got it there. He did not. They're going to say that's incomplete. We'll punt the ball. Just, you know, the way the defense is playing here, we're shutting down Trubisky, shutting down you know, best we can do with the run game, as now they're starting to go away from that run game as they dump it down to Montgomery there. And now third and seven as Trubisky looking to get rid of it. There's a first down there to Trey Burton. So if they found any really success through the air for first downs, it's been Trey Burton, as that's his seventh catch of the ball game, has a first down there. But another big third down here as we're into the fourth quarter with this Bears offense. That's going to be the outside. It's going to be, is that going to be incomplete? No, it's caught. First down there, Gabriel up to the 41-yard line. So the Bears need a quick score here. Down three scores. First and 10, Trubisky looking, caught, but he's laid out by Simmons. Oh, man. That's going to be incomplete. Second and 10 now. That's going to be another catch for Chicago, another first down. But we'll give you those completions. We'll give you those little underneath completions. You know, no big-time plays down the field. That's all we're looking for. Third and 14 as Trubisky somehow gets that over Keekly's head. I mean, he threw that kind of off his back foot on the run. Finds Allen Robinson there. First down to the 26. Second and 10 now to the outside. Another catch. First down there, Chicago. Down to the 9. So they're driving here. Second and 5. Trubisky looking in the pocket. Trying to find. He goes to the back of the end zone. And oh, man, Jalen Sapp could have had a pick there. That's going to be incomplete. Third and 5. Trubisky from the 9. In the pocket, can't find anybody down the field, finally dumps it down to Trey Burton. Nicholson there for the stop. So I think they go for it here, obviously, from the 8. Fourth and 4, Trubisky in the pocket, looking around, gonna go to the outside, and it's gonna be knocked away by Von Miller. That one's gonna be incomplete. So the Bears waste all that time driving down the field, cannot get anything out of it, and now with 6:20 left, we have a chance here to at least waste some more clock, put this game away here, up 24-3. Third and 7, Fields is going to find Ruggs, but he cannot hang on to the ball. That's going to be incomplete. So the Bears defense does their job, gets a 3 and out, puts their offense back on the field. But yeah, with 4:30 left, down 3 scores, not sure you're going to have to make some really quick scores here. So Trey Burton with the catch up to the 43-yard line, first down. And they're up, yeah, to the 43, 4 minutes left in this ball game. Trubisky dropping back. Burns coming, and Burns brings him down for the sack. He has just been a sack machine here the last, what now, 4 games. So count this game. I think that's 10 sacks the last 4 games for Brian Burns. Brings up a third and 23. They're going to dump it down to Montgomery, and there is just a swarm of Panthers there. Sherrod to bring him down. Fourth and 26 for this Bears offense. They're going to go for it, and this will pretty much be the ball game if they don't get this. Trubisky looking, and guess who it is? Brian Burns with the sack, forces the fumble as well. Man, the guy has been absolutely outstanding, and with that, that is the ball game there. 24-3 the score. I mean, our offense played well. We just didn't put up the points, but the defense absolutely dominant against the MVP, Mitchell Trubisky. Still weird to say, but man, what a game there in Chicago. Huge victory for playoff implications. Now that puts us 2 games by them, and obviously now gives us the tiebreaker if it ends up being so there, if we end up with the same record. McCaffrey, great game, 139, had the touchdown, so great 100-yard games back-to-back for Christian McCaffrey. Fields played absolutely outstanding as well. I know we only put up 24 points, but against this defense, it was, you know, we'll take it. We'll take the 24 points. The linebackers all over the place, but man, Brian Burns just comes up big late. Tamani Hill's actually had 2 sacks as well. Burns, what, 11 sacks now in his last 4 games? He is getting close. Well, he might be on a record-setting pace this year. That could be definitely up for Defensive Player of the Year award. There is no doubt about that. I mean, Brian Burns is not only turning into one of the best players on this defense or in the team, one of the best defensive players in the league. I mean, right now, he might be the best pass rusher going in the NFL. That is for sure. So he is, you know, it's funny how he started off slow in his rookie year and he kind of built up trying to find a role for him. And he has really turned into be an outstanding player as we try to find a deal with another outstanding player, N'Keal Harry. He wants more bonus, so we'll have to continue negotiating there. Brady, I know he's what? He's 32 years old. He'll probably drop down after the season with regression, but he'll still be a very good offensive lineman. And, you know, the whole thing with offensive linemen sometimes is just the integrity. and he will stay with the team. He'll sign a 2-year deal. That's the whole point of the offensive line. If you can have an integrity with them, they kind of get a rhythm with each other, that really makes things easier. And we'll try to make this offensive line intact. You see, the Saints ended up losing. Falcons lose. So actually with a victory here and a Saints loss, that could be the division. I think that's going to be the division. If we can beat the Falcons here and then with a Saints loss, that'll be another division title. So, man, that would be absolutely fantastic there. We'll see how things work out. Atlanta, you know, the team, we've always had the history with them losing in the playoffs. They've always been tough, but we have a chance to put them away here. If we can get this victory, we can almost put them out of the playoff race. But that's going to do it for this one. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you please leave a like, I'd really appreciate it. And subscribe, that'd be awesome. You guys are awesome. You guys have a good one. I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.